45, Royale Bombardier.
Royale Bombardier.
Number 4, Jen Bayshard.
Jen Bayshard.
Number 21, Kim Dragoon.
Kim Dragoon.
Number 42, Chantel LaValle.
Chantel LaValle.
Number 14, Aaron Macy.
Aaron Macy.
Number 13, Margarita Acero.
Margarita Acero.
Also tonight injured is Sarah Hartigan.
Sarah Katie Hartigan. Injured.
Starting for the Cougars at guard, number 22, Amanda Forey.
Amanda Forey.
At guard, number 41, Katrina Guerin.
Katrina Guerin.
At center, number 43, Mary Elizabeth Frankie.
Mary Elizabeth Frankie.
At forward, number 15, Megan Bayshard.
Megan Bayshard.
At forward, number 24, Danny Boris.
And Danielle Boris.
The coaches tonight for the Chiefs are Mr. Ron Cross, and for the Cougars, Mr. Dave Lambert. The officials for tonight's game are Bob Bloomfield and Barry Norton.
If there are any fifth or sixth grade girls that didn't fill out one of those slips of paper for the dribble, dress, and shoe contest, please do that now. Thank you.
Calvin Castine at Northeastern Clinton Central School. The Saranac Chiefs, the Miss Chiefs, are here for junior varsity girls basketball in the CVAC. Final home game of the year, final game of the year for the JVs. And the Cougars get the ball first. Saved by Boris and Christy Pajol called for being on the line. Ball comes in to Bayshard. Megan Bayshard turns, spins, misses. Rebound controlled by Myers. Caitlin Myers. Pass underneath. Is up and in. By number 42, Hillary Favreau. This is Guerin bringing it up. Guarded closely by Amber Parliament. Forey gives it out to Frankie. Frankie dishes off. Shot by Bayshard. Rebound is knocked loose. Picked up by Frankie. Frankie puts it up. Rolls off the rim. And the Chiefs have the ball. It's a 4-0 lead as Christy Pajol scores for the Miss Chiefs. Saranac. Full court pressure. Dave Lambert calls a timeout. Apparently sisters of one of the Saranac players said, I won't repeat her name because I'd be giving away which family it was. She said, we'll call it sis. Hey sis, get your head in the game, as they were coming out on the court. And her father said not to say that, but chances are she's just repeating something that her father has hollered out from the stands more than once. It's embarrassing sometimes when your kids start parroting your comments. And Caitlin Myers at the line, fouls on Boris. I believe the dribble and shoot contest will be at the halftime of this game. Senior night, and they've invited all the elementary kids to show up apparently again, but they never ever pass along what they're gonna do to me. I'm supposed to be taping it, but I never know what's gonna happen until it happens. And it's nice to be able to prepare. Chiefs bring it up, they lead 5-0. here in the early going. Chiefs get the ball. Nice effort by Myers, Caitlin Myers. Frankie into the forecourt. Stolen by Saranac. And it's a 9-0 lead. 9-0 Saranac. Corey over Frankie. 3-point shot is good by Katrina Guerin. Three, Cougars are on the scoreboard, traveling called. As we said, it's senior night, and they've blown up the four Cougar seniors and put their pictures on the wall. Jennifer Bayshard tracks it down. Frankie. Frankie stops, dishes it off to Megan Bayshard. It's blocked by Myers. And Chiefs turn it over. White ball. Ron Cross wanted the ball. Barry Norton's a little closer than Ron was. Is good by Bayshard. It's a 9-5 ball game. Chiefs hustle the ball down the floor and they lay it in. No idea what Saranac's record is. That was Hillary Favreau scoring. But if they win this one, it'll be a successful season, I'm sure. Doesn't matter what many losses they have, a win against the Cougars, and they'll call it a success. Mary, Elizabeth, and Frankie are all on the line right now. .355 on the clock. 11-6, the Chiefs lead. And they race it down the floor and penetrate, put it up and in. That's Favreau. Oh, Pajol, excuse me. Dragon got several subs in. Jennifer Bayshard stayed in, but four new subs. Ciro to Bayshard. Bombardier drives, throws it up and in. No foul either way. Nice move by Bombardier to put that in. LaValle with the rebound. Blocked by Myers, and she's out of bounds. That's at least a couple of blocks by Caitlin Myers. 13-8, Saranac leads. Off the rim, rebounded by Dragoon. And we're gonna have a foul called on 22, Fournier.
Oh, red, defense, red.
Dragoon will bring it up after getting the ball from Bayshard, gives it back to Bayshard. LaValle working her way in, and nice. Power move by Chantel LaValle. Always plays with a lot of heart. 2:12 left in the period. It's 13-10. Saranac was leading 9-0. There's a foul. A foul was on Bombardier. Myers shooting two. Second one is missed. Rebound Bombardier. She gives to LaValle off her fingers. Miss Chiefs will inbound it. They're up 14-10. Bombardier. LaValle puts it to the floor, rolls off the rim. LaValle fights hard, gets the ball back. We've got Macy in for the Cougars. Aaron Macy, 14. 1:21 remaining in the first period. Saranac up by four. Stolen away by Dragoon. Dragoon gives it to Macy. Macy tries to go to Bombardier, but Myers read that pass and picked it off quite easily. Cougars take it away, but give it right back. Another reach on Dragoon. Seconds to go in the first period. 14-10. Saranac leads. Macy almost had the steal. We have a traveler. Dragoon, 40 seconds. Dragoon for three. Yes, wow, good shot. And Kim Dragoon makes it a one-point ball game, 14-13. Here's a three for the Chiefs. A rebound inside position by Acero. Acero brings it up. Down to 6 seconds in the period. Up and in, and the Cougars have the lead for the first time as Margarita Acero scores. Ball thrown out of bounds by Saranac, so Northeastern comes from a 9-0 deficit to take a 15-14 lead after one here on Hometown Cable. It's Saranac ball to start the second period. Fournier and to Pajot. Ball comes low. The off red. Oh, off white. Once again, Barry Norton a little closer to the play. Looked like it was off the red from my angle, but that was at a first look. Norton's right there. Just a few feet away. Stolen away by Guerin. Seventh grader with the steal. It up to Frankie. She goes low for Boris. Frankie will inbound it. Megan Bayshard short. Rasko will inbound it. 15-14 Cougars with 36 seconds into the second quarter. Gets it into Frankie's fingers. Guerin drives, throws it up. Holy cow. Heck of a shot by Katrina Guerin. Travel. Mary Elizabeth Frankie will try to inbound it. Whoop, she's walking. She can't do that. She can't do that. Bloomfield calling it. Barry Norton should have caught that. After all those nice things we've said about Barry Norton, and something like that occurs right in front of him, and he doesn't see it. Guerin, the the bucket. Wrong cross. The potato chip man wants a timeout. 6:49 showing in the first half. Saranac down by 5. The Cougars think that's not enough. Over the back, I believe. Foul was on Fournier, according to the scoreboard. It's her third. The team has 4. She's got 3 of them. Frankie dribbles it up. Hands it off to Bayshard. She gives it out to Macy. Shot was missed. And we have a travel called. Ron Cross thought there should be some contact and a foul on that. Over and back. Macy did the smart thing, went out there and got the ball, let the refs make the calls. Almost stolen by Macy. Ooh, clean, but might have been somebody with a body. I'm going to give it to Boris, though, I think. Can't quite see a number, it might be 14. Looks like a 14, that would be Pajol. A rebound by Boris, this is the Bayshard. Corey to Guerin. Frankie out to Guerin. 19-15 Cougars. 4 on the shot clock. And we're going to have a foul. Foul is on Favreau. Okay. 21-15. 5:49 when the ball was inbounded. 3-point shot is too strong. Rebounded by Bayshard. Forey stops the dribble as it's slapped away. And Parliament misses the layup after getting that ball loose initially. It's Cougar ball. Chiefs will continue to press. Bayshard fakes, drives, lays it up off the rim, and the Chiefs come up with it. 5:04 to go in the second quarter. Shot too strong by Parliament, rebounded by Frankie. She pushes it forward to Bayshard. Megan Bayshard makes it 21-15. 4.5 remaining in the second period. Short. Guerin comes out with it. Kepit. Charge. She had Megan Bayshard wide open. That Megan Bayshard wide open. She gets called for the charge. 23-15, 4:12 on the clock. We're in the second quarter. Northeastern up by 8. They've outscored Saranac 23-6 since trailing 9-0. Take it away, Macy to Bayshard. Bayshard with the ball out to Bombardier. fouled. Chantel LaValle shooting two.
Open your eyes, Lab.
Chance to make it a 10-point lead, and she does. 25-15, 3:46 on the game clock. Cougars press, and we have a jump ball. Miss Chiefs will inbound it. On top of the key, basket's good. On Michelle Levine. Works it back outside. Bombardier to Macy. Macy throws it up and in off by Aaron Macy. 3:10 on the clock here in the second quarter. Cougars up by 10. Nice move. And basket put in by Pajol. Bombardier will go to the line.
Yeah, that's Moses.
Bombardier hits the first. Once again, chance to make it a 10-point ball game. Hits the back of the iron. Ciro and Dragoon in. They have a foul called. Stolen. And then the Cougars pick it up. It was Bayshard. Dragoon throws it up and in. Nice move by Kimberly Dragoon. It's at 30-19. Cougars' biggest lead of the game at 11. Zero. And it's Cougar ball. Less than two to go in the half. They start off the back of the iron. Rebounded for the Chiefs by Myers. Bayshard brings it into the forecourt. Double dribble called. Saranac ball. One Saranac fan saying, refs only see the fouls one way. Well, Cougars have 8 and Saranac has 7, so. By Dragoon. No foul called. White ball. Into a zero. 35 seconds to go in the half. Well, the dress and dribble and shoot coming up at halftime. Yeah. 32-19. expected, but Cougars get it right back. And a zero puts it in. 34-19. In and out. Out of door. 34-19. Northeastern outscoring Saranac 34-10 after trailing 9-0 early on. Stick around. We've got an exciting halftime coming right up here on Hometown Cable.
Tonight we'd like to honor our seniors, one of them who's been with us for 5 years in varsity, and three of them that have been with us for 3 years in varsity. This group has, so far, put together three undefeated league seasons in a row. Very admirable feat. But one reason we're able to have this success every year is because of the great job that our youth coaches do. And I try to thank them when I see them, but can never thank them enough. Because every year, they make us look smart here, because they keep sending us good basketball players. So tonight, we also want to recognize all of our future superstars. Okay, so I'm going to introduce the team and the coach and all the players. When I do introduce you, I'd like you all to come out on the court and stay on the court until all the teams are introduced. After we're done introducing all the teams, we're going to draw names of 2 5th graders and 2 6th graders to compete at the halftime of the varsity game in our dribble, dress, and shoot contest. If your name is drawn and you're not going to be here at halftime of the varsity game, just tell Mr. Dumas and he'll have you sub someone else in your team to do it. Also, once you get out here, the varsity girls will give you each a certificate for a free hot dog and a drink.
Woo-hoo.
All right, we're going to start with this year's modified team. This year's team, I believe, was 13-1. Alright, the players, Rachel Barco, Morgan Baker, Courtney Vaughn, Megan Boomer, Bailey Copeland, Allison Ebersol, Mara Fiveye, Katie Lynn Tierney, Mary Dominic, Megan Richards, and Chelsea Brooks. All right, from Ross's Point, third and fourth grade basketball team coached by Mike Rock, Tim Boole, Jennifer Hull, Keanu LeDuc. Come on down, please. Patricia LePan, Brianna Craper, Michaela Clark, Summer Verge, Alicia Lingfritter, sorry about that, Darian Carey, Taylor Jarvis, Samantha Rock, Kristen Carpenter, and Shauna Barkley. Champlain Stars, coached by Joe Southwick. Casey McKinnon, Paige Southwick, Bianca Grimshaw, Emma Dushar, Vada Lawyer, Taylor Carpenter, Paige McCauley, Amanda Harvey, Taylor Castine, and Caitlin Lucia. Morris Cougars, third and fourth grade, coached by Melissa Rabideau. Courtney Lepp, Justine LaBarge, Lacey Briette, Alexis Sorrell, Paige Dominic, Taylor Avenue. Christina Paola. Deanna Mangina. Aaron Niles. And Jennifer Bernard. St. Mary's, Lady Saints, coached by Dale Menard. Jessica Ashline. Kelsey P. Jacqueline Barthorne. Tori Dupre. Lacey Hogel. Chloe Salamone. Devin Goslin. Miranda Menard. Molly Roush. Skylar Heber. Jennifer Favreau, Hannah LaValle, Abby Miller, and Victoria Tatro. Chartwell's Cougars, coached by Carrie McComb, Ashley Launcher, Katie Launcher, Cassie Harvey, Mercedes Harmon, Caroline Currier, Kylie Rivers, Rachel Arliss, Harris Blades, Elizabeth McNeil, Shelby Underwood, Morgan Litton, Kayla McCall. John Bickhorn, Allison Ankill, Jenna LaValle, Andy Guerre, Ashley Guerre, Jordan Picor, Morgan Bennett, Lexa Perro, Krista Conley, and Orianna Flesh. Sandy's Country Kitchen. Coached by Malcolm Garrett, Courtney Rabbit, Madison Martin, Miranda Stevens, Morgan Rabbit, Taylor Blondo, Kayla Dragoo, Allie Cartier, Jordan Dominic, and Colette McLean. Lady Panthers, coached by Roland St. Spare, Erica Sorrell, Emily LaCourte, Justine Ravidou, Janelle Menard, Brooke Seymour, Christine Houle, Emily Norris, Amber Wallace, Savannah Swinton, and Stephanie Valley. Did I miss anybody? Alright, at this time we want to draw a couple names in the hat. Fifth and sixth graders are going to compete in the triple dress shoot contest. I will do 20 girls grab a name out of there. Switch down, shake them up, and grab a name.
Well, what's the most exciting part of the evening?
Cassie Harvey here.
Come on
over.
Cassie
Harvey.
Emily Norris.
Emily Norris.
Brooke Seymour here.
Brooke Seymour. Very reluctant. But Seymour.
The rest of you girls, we'd like you to go back to your seats now, but remember we want you back out on the floor before the start of the varsity game.
Before the start of the varsity game.
Thank you very much.
That's the halftime show. But more basketball coming right up here on Hometown Cable. The Mischiefs have the ball as we start the second half. They trail 34-19, 15-point Cougar advantage. Cougars led by one at the end of the first period. Look at this, Jim Patnode. Got a flower, he attends all their games, but even went to Malone for a game. And team got him a flower. Jim Patnode knew there were fringe benefits like that, he would have started coming to these games a long time ago. Got a flower, personally delivered by Tiffany Lamberton and the all-time leading scorer in the CVAC, who just might hit 1,800 points tonight, Courtney Coyer. Red ball. Bowers for the rebound. Ball off Frankie. M.E. Frankie. Interesting move by Amber Parliament. 36-21. Ball goes low to Bowers. She misses it. At the line. Foul was on Garen, her third. Fournier's second shot. Off the rim. Frankie with the ball gives to who else? Over to Garen. A long two-pointer. Foul was on the line. Trina Guerin. And scoring for the Mischiefs is Hillary Favreau. 38-23. From the elbow, shot put up by Frankie. Frankie snuck in there, followed Corey's shot, and gets an easy two right between the Saranac rebounders. Stolen by Garen. Zero at the line, shooting two. And Zero hits. 41-23. Favreau shooting two. That is missed. Rebounded by Asiro. Up to Macy. This pass to Asiro, puts it up too strong. Chiefs throw it away. Pretty good crowd here. Good numbers. Is here. One of the all-time leading scorers for the Cougars. Yeah. 41-24, 17-point lead for the Cougars. 3:09 to go in the third. Three-point shot is rebounded by Asiro. Goes it down from Bayshard, in, Jennifer Bayshard with a nice high arcing shot. Give the Cougars a 19-point advantage. And a basket by Christy Pajot. Chantel LaValle shooting. Parliament. Foul is on LaValle, her second. 44-27, 2:24 on the clock. Rebounded Bombardier. Bayshard will bring it up. Red ball. Stripped away nicely by Macy. Gives it to her cousin Bayshard, Jen Bayshard, and it's 46-27. 1:43. Showing here in the third period. To the basket by Hillary Favreau. 1:22 on the clock. 46-29. They've been playing fairly even the second half. Chiefs come up with the ball. 1 minute to go in the period. That's 46-31. They came into the half 15 points apart, and that's where they are right now. So Saranac playing the Cougars even. Scoring 22-28. 2 seconds to go in the quarter. Saranac has outscored the Cougars by a basket in the third period. Bombardier, a 17-footer. Maybe even closer to 18. 9 tenths of a second remaining in the period. 5 seconds to get it in. 48-33. Both teams score 14 in the third. We're going to the fourth on this Valentine's Day, February 14th, 2006. The Saranac ball to start the fourth quarter. The difference in this game is the second period. Northeastern outscoring Saranac by 14 in the second quarter. They lead by 15. Corey in the paint to Boris. Megan Bayshard is short. Rebound in the hands of Myers. Oh, nice turnaround. Caitlin Myers. 13-point ball game with 7:05 to go. This ain't over yet. Red ball. Too strong. Hands of Bayshard. Up to Guerin. Pass underneath is picked off by Myers. Megan Bayshard is down.
That one got the foul.
Bob Broomfield had no clue. He's calling the whistle because of a timeout. He had no clue that she was down. Bayshard walks off under her own power. Red ball. Stolen by Guerin. Let's see, a foul, I believe, the call on Boris, her third. Rebounded by Boris. 6:16 remaining. Frankie gives to Guerin. Tries to penetrate, nothing there. Ball slapped out to Frankie. Shot clock. 48-35, red ball. A three-pointer would make it a 10-point ball game. Bombardier picks it up. Rolls it up. Misses. Rebounded by Pajot. Red ball. Rebounded by Frankie. Over to Forey. Frankie takes it up short. Minutes and 48 seconds remaining, a 13-point ball game. Fournier will inbound it. Dropped in. Show who put it up. Well, it's an 11-point ball game. 4.5 minutes to go. Garand is blocked. Forey will inbound it. Oriel Bombardier gives the Cougars a badly needed basket. And the Chiefs answer, I believe that was Favreau hitting. 50-39. 4-10. Megan Bayshard back in, too strong. Frankie fakes, stops, pulls up, off the rim, rebounded and in by L'Oreal Bombardier. Megan Bayshard, oop. Like an extra step in there. Timeout red. 52-39, 3:39 on the clock. Folks arriving. Ready for the varsity game. Fouls on Dragoon, Fournier at the line. Myers will shoot. The team trails by a dozen. Back at 11. 52-41 with 3.5 remaining in the game. Ball comes in to Bayshard. Dragoon pushes it up to Macy. Macy stops. Goes off to the side. Air ball put up by a zero. Bayshard gets the rebound. Hands it to LaValle. LaValle tries to go to the hole and she's fouled. Until LaValle makes it 54-41. Family has arrived. Rebounded by LaValle. Bayshard keeps it. Not sure what the call is, if it was an offensive foul call or what. All I know is it's Saranac ball. Rebounds. 2.5 to go in a game. So Aragon hands off to Macy. Tool 6 remains. Cougars up by 13. Rebound by Bombardier. Saranac's turn on the jump ball. Pajot inbounds it. May have walked. Cougars turn on the jump ball. Dragon will inbound. Picked off. Foul on Acero. Parliament will shoot a 1-1. With 1:47 to go. Morgan Ashline at the line. They've got Ashlines in the Saranac district too. How about that? She could make this a 10-point ball game. 1:19 to go. Ball in the hands of Jennifer Ashline. Over to Dragoon. Back to Ashline. To the Jennifer Basha, excuse me. Ashline's on the brain. Clock just started. We've run off 6 seconds since that foul shot. Moose Misa. Got the home fans mad at him. Visitors want the more time. One thing to get the fans mad at you, but when it's the home fans, then you're in trouble. Who will get the ball back? And a zero puts it in. Where's the ball? There it is. Bayshard's got it. Macy, the Bayshard up to Dragoon, back to Macy. Who is up by 13, running the clock down. Short. Bombardier puts it back up short. Rebounded by Parliament. 4 seconds. There she is, Kaylee Rasko, with the recipient of that extra time. She got the points because of that extra time. So 2 points she wouldn't have got. 56 to, I don't know, they took the time off the clock right away here. 56 to 40-something, 45, I believe, is the final. Northeastern Clinton defeats the visiting Saranac Chiefs, and that's the way it was. Junior varsity girls basketball in the CVAC, February 14th, Valentine's Day, 2006. We got to switch tapes here. They're going to start talking whether we're ready or not. We know these people.
Good. All right, so. aim for that gray spot. When you're ready, you're going to go. On the right. Don't shoot yet, I'll just make sure that you proper alignment. That looks pretty good. When you're ready, go for it.